how can you trust again if you've been betrayed in your past or heartbroken before? That's what we're going to talk about in this episode. Hey everybody, I'm Mark from ApplyGodsWord.com, a place where we apply the Bible to your life. We talk about relationships, singleness, how to know your calling. Really, any question that you ask, I try to answer and apply the biblical principles that God has provided in His Word. So if you do have a question, let me know in the comments section. And if it's something that a lot of people are asking, I'll do my best to make a video on that. One of the most common reasons relationships struggle and sometimes even fail is because one of the people in the relationship have been hurt in the past. And so they allow these wounds, feelings of betrayal to get projected onto the person in their present, even though they're really, you know, living out of something that happened in the past. Therefore, the true solution to overcoming these feelings of betrayal with somebody that maybe hasn't even betrayed you is to focus on the actual source of the feelings that you're having. Maybe you were, your dad or your mom had an affair when you were younger and, you know, you grew up feeling betrayed, and then you get into a relationship as an adult and you just constantly feel like this person's going to cheat on you, or they're talking to someone of them from the opposite sex and you just instantly assume that they're doing something terrible or sinful. And, you know, you're not going to ever be able to overcome those fears unless you address the thing that actually happened in your past, because the feelings of betrayal really aren't with the person that you're with right now. They have to do with the things that have happened in your past. So the first way that you need to, that you can overcome feelings of betrayal is by forgiving the person that betrayed you. I know that sounds really simple, but it's really profound when you can realize I'm projecting a hurt onto someone in my present, even though I'm actually wounded by somebody in my past. The second way to overcome feelings of betrayal and, you know, getting into a new relationship, even if you've been heartbroken in the past, is by scaling the amount of trust you give somebody in a relationship. So the Bible says to guard your heart above all else, for it is the wellspring of life. It says that in Proverbs 4:23. Interesting enough, there's no Bible verse in the scriptures that commands you to trust people. We're called to trust God ultimately. That doesn't mean we're not supposed to trust people. It's just not a command. And the reason it's not a command is because that would be an over-application. You shouldn't trust everybody. I mean, there's people who are untrustworthy, and God doesn't say, well, just turn a blind eye and trust everybody. So what you want to do is you want to give yourself an opportunity to trust somebody. Rather than just hiding and being afraid of ever getting hurt, what you want to do is you want to get into a relationship and give people the opportunity to show that they are worthy of your trust. So you don't just stay away and stay super guarded. You are vulnerable in a wise, practical way, and scaling your vulnerability with the level of commitment that you're getting from the other person. So when you get into a dating relationship or some sort of relationship with somebody, you don't just lay it all out there on day one or instantly jump to this huge conclusion that you're going to be with this person forever. You slowly open yourself up to that person, and the more they handle the small things, the more trustworthy they are to handle the bigger things with your heart. This is really why the process of dating is so helpful with romantic relationships. It's supposed to start small and build to marriage. You don't want to come into it with all these expectations and hopes and just lay everything out there. That's when you end up getting hurt. Point three is that ultimately, if you want to trust somebody in a relationship, they're not going to be fully worthy of that trust. So ultimately, your trust in that person needs to be based in your love for that person. Your trust can be given to somebody even though you know they're imperfect and they're going to eventually hurt you in some way or the other because they're not a perfect person. You can still choose to be vulnerable and open with that person because you love them. Your trust can be an expression of your love. And love can't be based on merit. It can't be based on the other person's quality and perfections. So the way to finally overcome betrayal and heartbrokenness is not to look for the perfect person out there who's never going to hurt you. Yes, like I said in the first point, or the second point here in this video, you should scale it. You should give people opportunities to be tested and not just open your heart up to anybody and trust people who are trustworthy. But you can only take that logic so far, because everybody is going to let you down to some degree or the other. I'm not saying, you know, you're always going to get cheated on or someone's going to betray you in this huge way that you got betrayed in your past. But the way forward to overcome fears of betrayal and heartbrokenness is not to look for the perfect person, but to come to the realization that if you're going to love anybody, it's going to be because you choose to love them regardless of their failures. That you're going to say, I'm going to love you and I'm going to give you my trust, not because you're perfect, but because I love you. Because this is my expression of my love for you. This idea can really be seen in the way God approaches us. God trusts us, but not in a way where he trusts us in such a way where he says, I know you'll never wrong me. I know you'll be perfect and I know you'll meet all my expectations and everything. God's not saying, I trust you and I know you'll never fail me. What he does, though, is that in his love, he trusts us with his vulnerability. He's open to us. He gives us freedom to hurt him and to obey him, to love him or not love him, to do what he wants or not to do what he wants. He trusts us with the things that he gives us. He gives us money. He gives us other relationships. He gives you a wife or a husband or kids or a job. And in those, by giving you those things, he's trusting you with those things and, you know, wanting you to handle those things correctly, but also fully knowing that you're not going to do it perfectly. So why does he entrust us with these things? Because he loves us. He trusts us and gives us responsibilities with things that really matter to him. Again, not because he knows we're not going to screw up sometimes, but because he loves us. And that's ultimately how you're going to be able to overcome betrayal and heartbrokenness from past relationships. You have to say, you know what, I know this person that I'm in a relationship right now isn't perfect, but I'm going to love them. And that's what love is. It's giving things that are undeserved. So in summary, no one's going to deserve your trust, but in love, you can give your trust to them anyway. Well, I have more to say on this topic, but I'm going to leave a link in the description of this video for an article I also wrote on this same topic. And in that article, I go into this conversation a little bit more in depth, and I share some more Bible verses, and I give some good examples of how Jesus entrusted himself to people as an expression of his love. So if you're interested in that article, I will leave a link in the description of this video so you can check that out. Well, again, I'm Mark from ApplyGodsWord.com. If you haven't subscribed yet to this channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button. We're pumping out new videos like this every single week, multiple times a week. And we're trying to grow in Christ together, learning how to navigate this messy life for the glory of God. So if that's something that you're interested in, join this growing community on YouTube and hit that subscribe button. Well, thanks for watching and God bless.